The new Macro Builder window is great, but there might be times when you want to get your hands dirty in Visual Basic Code. This can be done easily a couple of different ways. One way is through a form or a report. When working with a form or report, you want to make sure that you're in Design Mode. In Design Mode, in the Design Tools tab, click on the Design tab, and on the right-hand side in the Tools group, click Convert Forms or Reports, Macros to Visual Basic. You'll see a dialog box asking if you want to add error handling to generate functions, and also asking if you want to include macro comments. Click the Convert button. Click OK. And that's it. So where would you find the code? In the Visual Basic Editor. The fastest way to enter Visual Basic is by clicking the Alt and F11 keys on your keyboard. That's Alt Function 11. That will take you into the Visual Basic Editor. On the left side of the screen, in the Project Explorer, you will see the current database that we're working in, which is Macro Training, as well as a folder for the objects in this database. We were in the Inventory List form, so I'll double-click on that to open it up, and there you have it. The macros have been converted to VBA. Another way to convert your macros into VBA is through the Macro Builder window. I'll go ahead and close my Visual Basic window and open up a macro window. In the Ribbons Macro Tools Design tab, in the Tools group, click on the Convert Macros to Visual Basic button. Again, you get the same dialog box asking if you want to add error handling to generate functions and include macro comments. I'm going to again suggest that you leave both of those checked. Go ahead and click on Convert. The macro is converted to VBA, and it automatically opens up your Visual Basic Editor.